Our panel, Jason, your thoughts on this?
Well, I'm not impressed with Secretary Price's defense of not flying commercial. Apparently, shortly after he became secretary, he missed an event because of backups at an airport, like all of us have been through, and now feels the need to fly on private planes. I think if Secretary Price cannot fly, except for taxpayer-funded private jets, that President Trump should find a new secretary.
Anna?
It just seems like such an unforced error, as the package said. I mean, he is a longtime member of Congress. He railed about this practice when he was in Congress. This is something that is a perennial story that reporters like me look at these public disclosures. There's a reason for them. So it's very hard for me to understand why his team, which has been around him for a long time, let this actually happen.
Yeah, Howard, there's the two parts of the story. Once this cascade started happening with the Price element of it, there was a look at all of the cabinet secretaries, and some organizations talked about Betsy DeVos, the education secretary, and The Hill had tweeted the headline, and it said, DeVos uses private jet for work-related travel, and that's all it said.
Right.
And, of course, you had to get down into the story to say, well, she pays for it, and she doesn't take reimbursement from the government.
Yeah,
so two sides of it.
A number of misleading headlines about Betsy DeVos. Yes, technically it is true. She's taking a lot of private aircraft, but she's a zillionaire. She is paying for it. She's also not taking a government salary. Look, for Tom Price to spend $300,000 on private jets in the space of just a few months, according to Politico, is not only off the charts, but it's exactly what people hate about the swamp. And the spin is so lame. I'm trying to connect better with Americans. In one particular case, spent $7,000 on a jet to the Aspen Ideas Festival. Well, I guess there are a lot of ordinary Americans there. And I just think that if there wasn't so much other news, hurricanes, earthquakes, Donald Trump constantly making news, this would be a much bigger story. In a way, Secretary Price is lucky that it's not the lead story.
I mean, do you think that there's going to be a big change here, Jason?
I don't think there needs to be a big change. I mean, I think it's kind of unfair to conflate these two stories. So the Mnuchin and DeVos and Linda McMahon are enormously wealthy people. They have spent their entire lives in the private sector. They are trying to bring this expertise to government. They're not there to leech off taxpayers. This is a hit job. I think that's really some fake news going on when it comes to what they've been doing in terms of their travel. And I think that the press would do better to focus on their policies and stop trying to impugn their character with stories like that. That's what this is. Tom Price is, I think, in a completely different league here.
Yeah, and listen, after what looks like it's going to happen with this next health care, Obamacare repeal effort, Anna, this is not a good week for the HHS secretary.
Indeed. I think that is very accurate. I think the real question is going to be, can they do any cleanup on this, or do they just hope that there's another kind of tweet storm by the president, or the North Korea crisis where it kind of all of a sudden, as Howie was saying, gets kind of, passed by because there's just such a deluge of information coming from the White House and from the administration and from Congress at all times, it seems, these days.
And it's particularly egregious.
I mean, Howie, that does happen, the shiny thing. Look at the shiny thing over here. But this is still a big story.
Particularly egregious when you're cutting your own budget benefits for real people and they read about these kind of private jets. It just makes people crazy.
Okay, panel, thank you very much.